Outside court, Sharon Mocha was composed and greeted by some applause from court watchers. But in the courtroom, she unleashed a scathing attack on the man she used to consider a son. She called Scott Peterson a selfish, heartless, spoiled, self-centered coward. And it was when she became the voices of Laci and Connor that many people in the courtroom began to cry. Quote, "I hope this echoes through your head for all eternity." Laci was thinking, "Scott, why are you killing me? What are you doing? I loved you. I thought you loved me too. Scott, I want to live. I don't want to die."
Touching, very touching. It's you have to sympathize with what the family's going through, and your heart goes out to them.
Scott's parents never heard Sharon speak. They left after shouting at the first speaker, Laci's brother Brent Rocha, who told Scott that he was an arrogant, spoiled rich kid and a loser. Brent continued, quote, "You are evil and still have the readiness to commit evil. I went to buy a gun. From the beginning, I knew you were guilty. I didn't kill you myself for one reason, so you'd have to sweat it out." As six members of Laci's family took turns yelling at Scott, he showed no emotion aside from once shaking his head no.
Probably the most infuriating things for the victims in this case is to have this killer still deny it to their face, take no responsibility.
Of the original 18 jurors and alternates, 13 of them returned to court today as Judge Alfred DeLucchi followed their verdict and sentenced Peterson to death.
What the judge did today clearly says that we did the right thing, and our work was for the right. We did everything right.
Laci's family had dinner with the jury earlier this year. Today they expressed their thanks for what they call justice.
Our family's going to make it. We're stronger because of this. And Scott got what he deserved.